Good afternoon. Today we're going to talk about a Mitel application entitled Audio and Web Conferencing. Today's video is going to be just a short little video on how to create or schedule a session. And please see other TransWest videos on how to host or manage a session once one has been created. So let's get started. What you'll do is you'll open a session of your browser and input the domain name to access your AWC login homepage. You'll input your login ID followed by your password and select login. Once you're logged in, you'll be taken to your unified communications portal, and since today's video is going to be strictly on how to set up an audio and web conferencing, we're going to come down to this tab here, which is going to take us to our homepage of our AWC to schedule a conference. But before we schedule a conference here, what we'll do is we'll have a brief little conversation about these tabs at the top of our screen. Once we complete having our conversation about some of these tabs and settings, we're going to come down to here one-time conference, and we will go through the process to set up a conference. But since we are at our home page, we're going to come to set up a conference. And this will take us just to a quick little link to set up a one-time, a reoccurring, or a reservationless conference. You can come to My Conferences and view any that you currently have scheduled. And you can, of course, invite, change it, or delete it out of your schedule. Recordings. If you choose to save any of your audio recordings or any of your web sessions, this is where they will be saved to be found at a later date. When you come up underneath your settings tab, let me move this up a little bit. Here you have four tabs. Of course, to change your password to log in, change the phone number where you will be notified at the scheduled phone at the scheduled time for the scheduled conference. By default, it comes up with your desk phone. Email invitations. You have two choices of email invitations that you can send out to your invitees. You have a long version and you have a short version. I prefer the short version over the long version. Myself, I feel that the long version is just information overload. So let me do this. Let me move this up a little bit. And we'll just do a quick little preview of what the short version is. You can play around with these and you can decide whether which version works best for you. But here's that short version. Of course, you'd address it. You could put a subject matter in and put some text into the body of your email. But in a nutshell, it has all the basics. The date and time the conference was scheduled, the phone numbers the parties must dial, followed by the extension number to come in, and lastly followed by an access code that they must dial to come into the audio portion. This link will be the link to allow them into the web portion, and then lastly, if they choose to add it to their Outlook calendar, they may choose to do so by clicking this link. So feel free to take a look at that long version, and you may find that that one works best for you. We'll come up underneath the Reports tab. And this is just a great little tool to review all of the conferences that you've had or held for a specific date range. So let's come on back up to this set up a conference. Now, like we mentioned at the beginning of this video, our goal here was to set up a conference. So we'll come and we'll just select a one-time conference. Let me move this up for you so we don't miss anything here. Our conference type, we wish to make this an audio and a web conference. The conference name, this is a required field. So we will just input a conference name and we'll give it a name of training. We'll pick a date. Let's pick Friday, April 15th at, say, I don't know, we don't want to go too early here, do we? Maybe say 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock in the morning. Nobody's such an early morning person around here that 10 o'clock will work. By default, comes up PM, so be very careful about this prompt here. Duration, we don't expect it to last over an hour. Conference size, we do need to have a detailed conversation about this conference size tab right here. Very important. This is a port-based application. So if your company is licensed and have purchased licensing and there are 8 ports available to you, then that means you are limited to the number of people that you can bring in. 8 parties, of those 8 parties, that would include 7 external parties plus yourself equals 8. Let's talk about, say that maybe you are only going to use 4 of the available ports. This tab right here, port availability tab. As an example, if your company is licensed for 8 ports and you're only going to use 4 of those ports for an hour, you do need to come to this application, this tab, to make sure that one of your coworkers hasn't reserved any ports for the same date, the same time that you're just about getting ready to do for yourself. So let's check our port availability here. Looks like for the 15th at 10 o'clock, duration of 1 hour, we're going to request to use 4 ports, and there are enough ports available because we can see that currently during that time frame there is an availability of 15 ports available. So we're good there. And we're going to go ahead and mark this conference as a published conference, so then when my coworkers log into their AWC portal, they can see that I have a scheduled conference. Billing codes with department and project, your choice on that. However you feel that your company will operate best. Call features. Again, this is where you're going to customize it to how you feel best. If you choose that you must be present for your external parties to dial in and come in, then you'll check this box. Roll call, this is a nice function here. Of course, with this checked, then when they dial into the audio portion, they are asked to record their name, and then it plays the name to the existing parties that are already in the conference, so we can all make our introductions that way. Now this join and leave tone, again, your choice, and we're going to come down to password protection. If you decide to password protect this conference, here's where you input the passcode determined by you. Let's input one real simple, such as the word help. That will be our password for this web session. So let's go ahead and include that passcode to the participants. So once we figure out the times and the functions of how we're going to operate this conference, let's go ahead and select OK. That will bring us to the conference detail page. If I choose, I could load any documents to this particular conference. Here's the body, name, duration, and conference size, the features that we've chosen, and over here, the access information. These are the phone numbers that all of your parties will need to dial, followed by the extension number to come in. And lastly, everybody will need these access codes, the leaders included. So these access codes must be dialed to come into the audio portion of the conference. So I would go ahead and email an invitation to the leader, whether that leader be you or you've designated somebody else as the leader. And of course, you never want to forget to send an invitation to your participants. So once you do, you'll address it, any information that you may need to include. And again, here's the phone numbers that will dial, followed by the extension number, followed by the audio access code, and here's that web link to come in, and here's that passcode. Looks like I must have had my cap locks on when I spelled that passcode, but it doesn't matter. And so that is how easily a Mitel audio web conference session can be created and placed upon a calendar. So, please see other TransWest videos on how to host a session and enjoy using your Mitel audio web conferencing. Thank you.